You said you hate me and you wish I could find you. Okay, you love me, maybe I speak your language. Saying things you don't mean.
What song is
to
this?
Someone that means the world to you. You see what I mean? Saying things you don't mean to someone that means the world to you. You see what I mean? You said you hate me and you wish I would brand you. Okay, you love me, but I speak your name. Saying things you don't know.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to KIPP NYC Theater Company's presentation of House of Cards. You can clap it up. And this being our first time back to the theater, we are so welcome and happy that you are here. We just want to remind you, please make sure that you remain 3 feet apart, that you stay masked up at all times, and absolutely no food is allowed in the theater space, as we want to make sure that we are following COVID protocols. We appreciate you guys for spending your time with us tonight and seeing this wonderful presentation that our students are going to do. And now, for our presentation of House of Cards.
Thanks.
complicated. A lonely person in the school with best friends, ex-friends, acquaintances. I guess I'm afraid this will be stuck forever.
I come back from the summer vacation from my senior year and not a single person has changed. None of the cool people will even give me the time of day. It's our senior year for crying out loud. I thought some people would have actually matured over the summer, but I guess there's no use in trying to hang with cool people after all. They're also stuck in themselves and each other. At least I know who my real friends are. So what if we watch reruns of Riverdale and play Uno against ourselves just to see who wins first? At least it's fun.
What am I doing? Packing my backpack, of course. Then why am I packing a stuffed octopus? I guess this might be why people think of me as eccentric. But you know what? I like being in my stuffed octopus. Everyone knows me as stuffed octopus from math class, right? Ah, yes. And I can't forget about Philip, my lucky Chuck E. Cheese token. Philip is a girl, by the way. She and I have been together ever since elementary school. And guess what? I haven't got hit by a single bus yet. A couple cars, yeah, sure, but they're all driven by the face guards. Take it from me, but I think there is a vast left-wing conspiracy out to destroy me and all the other psychopaths. I know it. But who really needs face cards as your friends anyway if you're just better off by yourself? Yesterday, me and Philip were talking. She says she secretly works for the FBI and one day she'll just turn me into the feds without me knowing. Sometimes I think Philip is delusional. But she listens to me when I talk. Tomorrow, Jack will ridicule me with his third grade level vocabulary. Whatever.
Wasn't that funny?
A little funny.
You should have seen what happened to him. So, you know that you caught seven, right? So me, Queen, Jack, and King were all just hanging out, right? And Seven totally tried to come over and be all cool. But she doesn't understand that she can't sit with us because she's a Seven. Look. So, I took this opportunity to heighten my status with King and told her that her face was like a war zone acne. I mean, it was a good move on my part because they told me that I was cool for it. And it guaranteed me a spot made at the table. Nines in front of me wanted to know why I hadn't been hanging out with the Nines race league. And I just said I didn't like them anymore, or didn't feel appreciated by them. But the truth is, I never felt underappreciated by them, or disliked by any card below me. I always felt awesome, but something was always missing. Whenever I saw the face cards in the hallways, they always looked so different, special. Even famous. I mean, to an extent. I always wanted a piece of what they had. I mean, they're really nice and cool cars, but I always wanted to walk with them in the halls, sit with them at lunch, go to the malls on the weekends. I finally found the key. Why would I give that up now? I mean, anyways, I have to go to Jack's house later and watch SNL. God, I hate that show. But imagine me at a face card's house? I'm gonna pretend to like it. Because if I don't, you're gonna kick me out. And I won't have anyone to sit in that bench. Except for Ace. I don't think you two or three can sit.
Oh.
You know the difference between me, my group, and the popular group? One called the loser, geeks, and so on. It makes us feel terrible sometimes. Other talking people, be honest, we don't exist. Maybe we don't in their world. But at least I have good friends. I have good friends I can rely on. Their friends, that's the difference. My friends are real and forever, while their friends are fake.
And I'm stuck between
team, the nines and the tens and the twos and the threes have a place to sit. I can't hang with the nines and the tens because I'm not good enough for them. And I will not be caught with losers this year. This year is just like last year. Same old crap, different day. And I don't know how much more I can take of this. My life just pretty much sucks. Pretty much.
Thank you. Because they have it easy. They don't have any pressure on them. That means kiss them as long as I compliment them. Why should I have to? They're a bunch of snobs. I don't want to be a snob. If I'm not popular, does that make me a geek? How can a 6 be a geek? To be fair, I'd rather be a geek than a snob. When I saw this guy earlier walking down my mom for an app class, he was dancing weirdly. He was enjoying it too. I guess that's because he's, oh my god, that's it. I just don't care what anyone else thinks. If I'm not a geek right now, I'll become one tonight.
Oh yeah, of course I'm cool. Don't you know who I am? I hang with a crowd that everyone else wants to hang with. In fact, I'm almost the leader in my group. The only person who's much more popular is King, who I think talks about behind my back. Come to think of it, I don't think any of my other friends like me as much as Hank's wife. Oh my King, I hate this fake is with your image, this assumption that I'm better than for some new reason, from watching other people, many of them I've never seen before, I decided that their friendships need to be way more real than ones I have. They never really seem to worry about whether their friends really like them or not. So I decided a few days ago I was going to go out there, meet some new people, make some new friends, of people who said they were below me. Easy, right? Ha! Wrong! Every single group I pushed up to me, I felt everyone wanted to trust me. I guess I was wrong. Eventually, I went back to my old group. It was kind of weird at first, but they treat people with respect when I love them. I know they'll be off gossiping about this the first chance they get. But I guess I belong with those guys whether I like it or not.
Thank you.
felt alone. I embraced the presence of my friends only because they're cool too. Of course, not as cool as me. Why the Lord cries for their time trying to be like me is beyond me. They should spend time doing things they're good at, such as picking up my trash. After all, that's what they're good for, right? And that's the perception everyone has of me. I've been forced into playing this role. I've been playing it for so long, I started to do the tour I really am. I honestly don't intend to be mean to people. It's just, I have problems too. I have days where everything makes me cry. School, homework, boyfriend, future, lack of future, fear in general. I honestly can't deal with the problem as an emergency. Yeah, I have days like that too.
Thank you.